All right, so we are going to get in, started with our final installment of this week. So we're starting with passage 7. So I'm not going to read these things first. I'm going to go straight to the question, starting with 35. Which of the following hypotheses was investigated in experiment 1? Anytime it asks you about what they did in the experiment, that's an SIN question. So experiment 1, now we flip back to here, go to experiment 1. 6 healthy cows were divided into 2 equal groups. Group A's feed included meat from Scrapey Free Pie. Group B's feed included meat from Scrapey Infected Sheep. Oh, Scrapey. I saw the word pie and so I read it, but I should have said sheep both times. 18 months later, the two were slaughtered. Oh God. The two groups were slaughtered and their brains examined for BSE cavities. So we are trying to figure out why and if the cows get this. Now, what's the difference between these two groups? It's the food that they were eating. So, Scrapey infected sheep. The injection of Scrapey infected sheep brains into cow's brains causes BSE. We did not inject. The ingestion of wild grasses causes BSE. We did not do wild grasses. The ingestion, that means eating it, by the way, if you ingest something, of Scrapey infected sheep causes Scrapey. No, that's not what we tested. We tested for BSE. And we had them eat Scrapey infected sheep. So, there we go. The answer to 35 is D. Okay, 36. What is the purpose of experiment 2? SIN questions. These are all SIN 501, which you guys actually tend to do pretty well on. So, we'll see. So, experiment 2. Researchers injected ground-up sheep brains directly into the brains of 2 groups of 30 healthy cows. Sorry, I've read this one before, but I forgot about it, and it's really gross. So the cows in Group C received brains from Scrapey Free, Group D, brains. So what did they do? The purpose was to determine if what? So let's match our key terms. To determine whether BSE can be transmitted by injection. That's part of it. To determine whether BSE can be transmitted by ingestion, it's not going to be G because that's what we did in experiment 1. And it's not asking us to compare. It's just asking about experiment 2. So experiment 2 didn't do ingestion, so we can cross off H because ingestion is only experiment 1. Experiment 1. To determine the healthiest diet for cows. That's definitely not what they were trying to do if they were putting sheep brain into cow brain. So the answer is F. Okay, 37, moving along. Which of the following assumptions is made by the researchers in experiment 1 and experiment 2? If we say assumptions, that is going to be EMI, always. Always assuming is EMI. So, cows do not suffer from Scrapey. 1.5 years is sufficient amount of time for BSE to develop. Cows and sheep suffer from the same diseases. Cows will not eat Scrapey. Free meat. That's not an assumption because that's what they were trying to figure out. So that's a hypothesis from question number 35. So we can cross that off immediately. So what did they both make? What assumptions did they both make? Let's see. A series of experiments was performed to determine the mode of transmission of BSE. And whether or not they have Scrapey doesn't really matter. So let's see. 18 months later. 18 months later, both groups were slaughtered, and we looked for disease. So, cows do not suffer from Scrapey. That's not really going to impact us here. Scrapey was not in the experiment. That was not in the purpose. So that means that we can also cross off C, because we don't really care if they suffer from the same diseases, because we're not giving them the same diseases. We're giving them a cow disease. Bovine means cow. It's actually mad cow disease, I believe. Bovine spongiform. Yeah, it's basically mad cow disease. So, B. Both of them say 18 months. You have to know that 18 months equals 1.5 years. That's prior knowledge that the ACT is going to assume that you know. But the answer to that one is B. All right, 38. What color are we gonna do? Let's go crazy. Let's go with yellow. A researcher wishes to determine whether BSE can be transmitted through Scrapey-infected goats. Which of the following experiments would best test this? This is a question about an experiment, so it is SIN again. That is really hard to see on the video. All I did was underline which of the following experiments would be best. So, now we want to see if they can get it from goats. So, repeating an experiment using a mixture of sheep and goat meat in group C's feed. Repeating experiment 1 and 2 with replacing sheep with healthy goats. We don't want them to be healthy. And I don't think that experiment 1 had a group C. Yeah, and that would be a mix. This would be a mixture, so it wouldn't tell us which one they got it from, so that's just bad science. Okay, repeating experiments 1 and 2, replacing healthy sheep with healthy goats, and scrapie-infected sheep with scrapie-infected goats. That sounds pretty logical to me. I'm going to put a check next to it. Repeating experiment 2, replacing healthy cows with healthy goats. That completely changes our experiment. So, all we want to do is, where there were sheep, we want to put goats there. But, we don't want, like, sheep... We don't want only healthy goats. We need to have both values. So, for this one, it's just you redo the experiment, changing as little as possible. Changing one thing. That says redo experiment, changing one thing. And remind me never to use yellow for these annotations again. I am sorry for your eyes. All right, which is the control group in experiment 1? S-I-N. So, control group, remember, is the whole group that they do nothing to. So, group A is scrapie-free sheep, scrapie-infected sheep, and there's only two groups. So there's group A and group B. So we want the one that are not infected, right? If you don't do anything to them, you're not going to give them an infection, so that would be group A is your control. And last question, EMI, because it says conclusions are supported. That is an EMI question. Cows that are exposed to scrapie infected sheep are more likely to develop BSE than cows that are not. BSE is only transmitted by eating scrapie free. A cow that eats scrapie infected is more likely to develop than that is injected. So this is the first time where we actually have to look at their results. So, do we have two tables? Okay. Oh, no, we have one table. All right. If they were fed, so group A is their control group. Group B is the one that was eating bad sheep. That's pretty high. If you were injecting healthy brain, that's a no. And then if you were injecting unhealthy brain, that's a little bit. So it looks like feeding has more than injecting, right? So ingest is higher than inject, so let's find that out. Cows that are exposed to scrapie infected, yes, those numbers were higher both ways, so yes. BSE is only transmitted by, no, because they had it. A cow that eats scrapie infected meat is more likely to develop than scrapie infected sheep brains. Also that's on our table. So 1 and 3, our answer is H. Cows that are exposed to scrapie infected sheep are more likely to develop than cows that eat. No, you're good. Yeah, you're good. It's H. Okay.